Chinese theater is deeply rooted in a history and a tradition that goes back 6,000 years. In fairy tales and romantic legends, in fabulous costumes and resplendent uniforms, 60 centuries come alive again on the Chinese stage. 600 million people find passionate enjoyment in this total spectacle. Opera, ballet, pantomime, circus, comedy and tragedy, all in one. Princesses and villains are as familiar to Chinese audiences as Punch and Judy, as Paul Bunyan and Donald Duck would be to the American public. At the Peking Opera, traditional makeup and costume identify the player. No program notes are needed to tell the spectator that here is a general leading his armies, symbolized by the array of banners which surround him. Princesses have ivory complexion, and the traitor's face is daubed ghastly white. The Monkey King's makeup is red on white ground, because red is the color of daring. The legend of Monkey combines elements from Adam's story, tasting the forbidden fruit in the Garden of Eden, and from the tale of Prometheus, who took fire from jealous stars. A long red beard is sure sign of a black soul. A flowing white beard, on the other hand, announces wisdom and experience. An inoffensive person wears no makeup. This is Yang Xuxian, beloved of a fairy, who believes he has been unfaithful. The maid would not hesitate to put him to the sword, but her mistress wishes to spare him. Hers is not the hatred of a woman scorned. She feels the subtle pain of love immortal, which the delicate play of her hands and the plaintive lines of her aria try to express.
The music and the songs are the most pure way of transferring Lakota culture and values and basically attitudes about life.
They sing of somebody way back before reservation time, when the people were moving about. Or since that time, they remember somebody. Somebody is remembered in a song. And this way, you know, we know about the past history as well through dances or through songs. A certain part of a song makes you feel good because of the words. And those words tell you something. They tell you a story. So you actually act out something while you're dancing.
The drum is the heart of the Lakota people. Guys who sing, or the drum keepers, you know, they have to know what it's all about. They have to know this stuff.
I put a lot of risk.
Oyate Wanjibila, all nations as one. Eagle dance is a prayer to the Great Spirit. The dancer asks for a blessing on the people as he imitates the soaring of the eagle, a symbol of Wakantanka, the Great Spirit. The whistle imitates its cry.
My Lord, deliver Daniel, deliver Daniel, deliver Daniel.
Did my Lord deliver
Daniel? Did my Lord deliver him, and why not every man? Did my Lord deliver Daniel, deliver Daniel, deliver Daniel?
Did my Lord deliver
Daniel? Did my Lord deliver him, and why not every man?
He delivered Daniel from the lion's den, Jonah from the belly of the whale, the Hebrew children from the fiery furnace.
And why not every man? Did my Lord deliver Daniel, deliver Daniel, deliver Daniel?
And why not every man?
traditional dance. The dance is the heartbeat of the Lakota people. The rhythm is part of everyday life. Buffalo spirit lives on in the dances of today. The shawl dance is a typical powwow dance adapted from the southern tribes after World War II.
Thank you. film music, the unseen factor in the making of movies. Of all the elements of film, it's the hardest to describe. It's reasonably easy to talk about acting, writing, directing, photography. But music, well, even composers have trouble talking to producers about what they think the music will do for the picture. And producers are sometimes not sure even when they hear the music. The main consideration is always this one. Does the scene need music? Let's look at Loretta Young climbing that ladder again, first without the music. The scene is tense, but maybe it can be more so. Let's add Bronislaw Caper's music. Now Loretta's fear and courage are accentuated. The music is an added dimension. Film is generally regarded as a visual experience. Actually, it isn't. Like life itself, we experience a film through our ears as well as our eyes. And no one knows that more than someone who writes music for film. Contrary to popular belief, the movies have never been silent. Even during those early years, there was always music. It might have been live musicians on the set who helped capture the mood of a scene. Or at the local Nickelodeon, a creative pianist added more emotional realism, dramatizing the magic of the movie flickering above the audience on the silver screen.
Coi chừng đằng sau. Mau lên, đi. Bây giờ, nhanh lên. Chạy. Chạy lại lên. Nhanh lên.